Hello, my friends, and welcome to Anneli's Journaling in Sweden. Last night I continued work with my scraps, and I did a few more pockets that I'm going to sew. And we are actually going to do some more today. But we are going to do this in collaboration with Craspire. That's a company that is mostly famous for their stamps. The wax seals. And I know everyone had shown those wax seals. So when I got a question from them again, I said that I already had done a video for them with the seals. And then she said, you need to check it out again because we have now laces, we have ribbons, we have different kind of scrapbooking paper. So, of course, I said I would try it again. So here I am now with my laces and ribbons. So, and these are some vintage paper pieces, scraps kind of, that I also got from them. And I got this super big pile, so I guess I have these kind of papers for a long time coming. But they are cute. A lot of old scripts, invoices, cute minis. So these are going to be used today. And we are going to make some more of these pockets or tuck spots to put in journals. So let's start and see what we can accomplish today with the help of this. I actually don't think I ordered this one with the yellow. I think it was the blue one, but this was the one that came. I'm actually not fond of these yellow flowers. Or you all know that I'm not a yellow wish girl. So I actually think I'm going to try to change this yellow to another color. But we'll see how we make that later. This was a really beautiful lace that they also had. So I decided to try that out. And this is so wide, so I'm going to use the piece of textile on it as a base for my journaling card. So you can use it for different things, and you have this kind of lace end on them hanging down, so that's cute. So you can use that too, not that just the lace. Maybe should have ironed this. It's been in a bag since kind of April, I think, or May. So let's see. Try to get this get the shape with a kind of this one in the middle. I think we need to cut it off a little bit. It gets too big. Can use those for snippets later. Should we go for three? Put this aside for now. Some antique book paper. It's never wrong to start with. Something like that. And then I'm thinking maybe something embossed to use. Check if I have something in my pile. That one I think we need to have. And that one. Those are cute. I have used up the embossed scraps. They always go first. Take a wallpaper scrap. Put that down there on that side. Today we have actually had some rain in Sweden. It was so nice. Has been so warm and dry for several weeks now. So it was releasing with some rain pouring down today. So I have actually been outside on my in my garden and cut the lawn and been checking on my vegetables. I try to make my own at least salad, tomatoes and some beans. So they are growing perfectly, but they needed something to climb on and hold on to, so I had to do kind of a little fence for them with sticks so they won't go anywhere, climb up, not fall down. Okay, should we see if we can use some of these papers? Kind of like this with the letter prints on. Crumble them a bit so they look a bit more old. They wasn't so shiny, so I really like the paper quality. Sometimes when you get things from China, they are really shiny and doesn't look old at all, even if the print is old looking. But this works. I really don't know how I will get through kind of 10 packs. I didn't realize there were so many in that order. I maybe did something wrong. I thought it was 10 pieces in each pile, but it was 10 piles. So something like that. I think we're going to use the blue ribbon. And then we need some lace. Want this ruffle on it. Want it to be a bit rough but not ruffled. Then this one holding it in place, that will work. It have dots on both sides, so you can put it how you want. They look the same on the both sides, that I love. I kind of often have problems with just that, to see which side is the right side to put down. I will sew these on my sewing machine and maybe do some embroidery on them later. So we just need to keep them in place for a little while. Maybe I would like some focal point on them.
maybe just some beautiful label. These labels are from Chapter 1 papers. I really love these colors in pink and turquoise, and so that is a favorite. Felt like it needed something more. Too white in my taste, so I need to tone it down a bit. See if that's more fun. Not sure about that. I'm just looking for something to back it with. I think I will go with the brown paper. Really like that. ribbon, but I'm still not sure about this. I felt like it needed something more. I think I need to go and get some photo. I found these little girls. I think that would go nicely to the blue. To make this a bit smaller, but still want the brown paper to peak, so I'm not cutting it. I'm ripping. Put this down first. Maybe we should crunch these up a bit too. They were too neat. Maybe do a little fold. I think we need to put it down by the lace. Do we like that? I think that was cute. Okay, let's move on. So a background or something. Maybe something pink this time. maybe a pinkish envelope. Like this flower. Looking a bit like watercolor. Crumble it. Let's put that on the other side. Now I'm thinking we need to have a piece of the lace. See if we can maybe rip this. that's nice, then we get this little rough feeling. See if we can rip it the other way too. That's cute. I didn't want to cover that up. Maybe we should just leave it as it is. A little date, maybe. '01, that could work. And this was also cute. I'm taking off the black. That is a bit too boring. That's better with the pink. I'm not sure if I'm going to use this, but I'm going to at least try to cut it out in a fun way. Thinking some of these roses. We have different pinks, and we have also these peachy ones. Oh, that was nice to that brown. That was also cute. And then we have this pink. Maybe this one. Help me. I actually like that one. probably because it got together with that one. But you can see there are so many nice colors to choose from. Different red, and there were more colors too. But nothing blue, so that was a little sad. I love the blue, you know. No. Maybe some white behind it. Maybe a piece of handmade paper. Are you like that you can see right away when you do your craft where things should be, or are you kind of trying everything before you decide? I mostly are deciding right away. I can see no. This won't go with the other colors, or yes, this is perfect for the thing I try it to. I'm rather quick to decide most of the time. I need to find the pink distress ink and give that tea a little pinkish tone. I find the archival ink, but I think I have a I guess I have put it somewhere. Seem to disappear things when you have it a bit too much things on your desk. Kind of. Can see if this can work. If it's too reddish pink. actually that was kind of all right. Can tone it down with a little bit of the distress ink. Try to get it more like this pink. Not float together, but almost. These ones. These are so cute to put on small snippets. Tone this white down a little bit more. And then our little label. Down on the lace. In my last recording, I asked if there was an interest in doing a basic journal, kind of the your first journal to make for newbies. And I got a few answers that was positive to do that. So I thought I could do that parallel with my white journal that I made the cover on. A couple of recordings back. Because that one is also kind of from the start. This one that I made the cover and put the linen on the inside. So I will sew these and put some more things on it, and then I have take my papers and made two signatures that I will sew in to this one. So this will also be a tutorial how to make a journal with a soft cover. So we can do both different days and just continue with those of you that are a little bit more used to making journals, and also make one for those of you that are new into this, and I hope I can inspire you to continue, because this is so nice to do. So a couple of journaling pockets, journal pockets, and using Craspire's roses and lace and this ribbon. So I will go and sew these, and then I will show you the result in the end of this recording. So thank you for watching, and I will link these roses and things from Craspire down below with links, so you can find it if you're interested in getting them. They had a lot of fun things now, so go and check them out. I was afraid they would just have the wax seals still, but no, they had a lot of different things now to play with. So that was fun. Thank you, Craspire, for letting me try out your products. I can say that this is a positive thing to have tried. So go and play, folks, and I will be back making more things and start the newbie journal some of the days, upcoming days. We are celebrating midsummer here in Sweden on Friday, so I will probably go out with my trailer in the forest and maybe by the lake, and I can record and show you something from that too, but I haven't decided yet. It depends on the weather. I don't want to go to the lake if it's pouring rain. Then it's not fun to be out in the forest and the nature with Nico getting all wet and sandy. So we'll see how that will end up. So thank you for watching, and see you soon again. Until next time, bye bye from Sweden.